Backups are important for data continuity. If your data source gets corrupted and you have a fresh backup, then you can get your business up and running again in no time. But you have to take backups for this to work. In this video, I'll show you how to automate the backups of your make scenario blueprints so you can have peace of mind that your business is disaster ready. Hi, my name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. I do want to point out that from the Make Scenario Editor, you can export blueprints manually right down here on these three dots, and you can click Export Blueprint, and you can save those as a backup to your scenario. But I'm not going to go much further than that because who's going to remember to do that? I don't know about you, but I'm certainly not going to. So I'm going to show you this three-step scenario that will back up all of your scenario blueprints to Google Drive in this case. If you're as excited about backups right now as I am, please hit the like button on this video and consider subscribing so that YouTube will know that this video needs to be shown to more backup nerds like you and me. So we're using the Make built-in modules. To use this, you're going to need a Make API key, and I'm going to link to a video that shows you how to generate that right now. Assuming you have that and you have a connection created, you're going to need to enter either your organization ID or your team ID. You can get this from the URL of your organization or team page. I've entered my organization ID, so we're going to download all the scenarios for my organization. And then I've got a limit here of 1,000. I have less than 400 scenarios on my account, but I want a number here that's high enough that as I add, we're not going to miss backups because the number's too low. So I have a filter here. And I would recommend that you run all of your scenarios and back them up before you add this filter. Purpose of this filter for me is I want to only back up things that have been edited in the last 7 days. So I have this formula here, the format date. I'm using the add days function to go back a week and say anything in the last week that's been edited, back that up. Once we get past that a week, and if it's not been touched, I don't want to keep backing those up unnecessarily. The other thing I'm doing is I'm just making sure that when this runs, there is a scenario ID so it doesn't throw any errors. Our next module here is going to map. You're going to map that scenario ID from number one. And then this is simply going to download that scenario blueprint. This is going to download it as a file. And so now we're ready to save it to Google Drive. So over here is our Google Drive. I have mapped that to a folder called make.com blueprint backups. I'm really creative when it comes to making folder names. And then I'm going to map that to that folder. I'm actually going to format the date, so the date that it was saved, the team ID and the scenario ID, and then save the blueprint data. So when this runs, it's going to find all of the scenarios that were edited in the last week and save a copy of that blueprint to Google Drive. I hope this video has been helpful. I thank you for watching. And if you have any trouble building this scenario or any of the scenarios as you add automation to your business, reach out to us at weblitica.com and we can co-build those scenarios with you and teach you some things about make and building automations along the way.